This is an incredible second season of Crossing Swords. Was it always this particular storyline continued you wanted to go with, or did you guys want to pick up with something new? What was going through your mind when you're like, okay, second season, here's what we want to do?
Well, because our story is about Patrick, and Patrick starting from scratch and being really idealistic and having this dream, we knew we needed to continue his story as he keeps trying to achieve this dream, even though it costs him in sort of every conceivable way. It chips away at his morality. It makes him feel bad every single day, and it gets him into all of these scrapes. And so that's Patrick's story, and we know we're always going to stay true to that. And then the rest of the season is just sort of an excuse to have these big adventures in brand new locations with brand new characters. And that's where all the fun is. And so, we always knew what the big story sort of is always not exactly set in stone, but we know what it is. It's Patrick. And then it's a matter of having fun in every episode, which is where we really enjoy ourselves.
There's some great new characters this season, John. Were these voices you had in mind for specific actors, actresses, or did these people just come across your path and you're like, okay, I think they would be good for this?
Root, that's a good question, Mr. Root. He did the voice directing. Root, how did all that happen? You know
Well, a
it.
lot of there were some happy accidents this season. Like, for example, in our premiere, season two premiere, William Jackson Harper plays a knight who is teaching Patrick the ways of knighthood, and giving him all of the wrong lessons. And we were really lucky to get him to do the voice, and it was one of those things where we didn't write the character with anyone in particular in mind. We just were sort of brainstorming and thinking, like, who's our dream casting? Who's on our radar? Who would be really funny? And giving it a try, like maybe he would do it. And a lot that like a lot of we tend to have a lot of happy accidents on this show. Like Nick Holt as Patrick was a happy accident where it's just like, oh, Nick is looking for he's interested in animation. Oh, we didn't know that. Well, come on in, let's meet. Like, and it worked. And so yeah, I mean, sometimes like we always knew Natasha Lyonne we wanted as that Yeti in season one, but it's rare that we get to like cast it in the writer's room as we're writing it, and then it actually works. It usually doesn't work like that.
It's been so hard for me to pick a favorite episode. I've seen a few of them so far. Do you have a particular one that stands out, maybe that viewers should look out for this season, John?
I love so many of them, but I think my favorite is the one where it's the circus episode. Seeing Merriman at the circus and excited for the circus is really endearing and cute, and it's something that I find really fascinating, and the characters that we have in that episode I think are really fun. So I would say circus is the winner for me. Root, how about you?
I really enjoy the Destination Wedding episode, but I was really excited to go to Blossom's boarding school because it was such a slapstick episode. There's so much physical comedy in that episode, and we get to see Broth and Patrick go undercover, and it's just ridiculous, kind of from start to finish. And that's one of my the that was one of the fun episodes, the most fun episodes to write for sure.
think the episodes just get better and better now in season two. What do you think it is about Crossing Swords that just has made it such a fan favorite, fast fan favorite too, series?
I mean, that's a good question, because I think we make the show in a vacuum. We kind of are trapped in, I mean, especially now in pandemic world, we're very insulated from the outside world, like everybody is. And we kind of make the show as best as we know how to make it. And we keep putting one foot in front of the next. And down the road, somehow we end up making a show, and it, you sort of forget all the steps that you took to get there. So we're lucky that it turns out well, because it is it's a long process, and it's easy to get lost along the way.
Well, if anyone hasn't told you yet, you've done a wonderful job.
Thank you so much.
Glad humor. You like it. And setting against the grain of of what people tend to really have, you know, old fashioned knowledge of stop action comedy and animation as well. So thank you both so much for bringing some levity to the times that we're in and for your time right now.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, thanks for talking to us.
My pleasure. Be safe and be well.
Yeah, you too.
Thank you too.